I'm not the type of person to buy a whole new computer just because one or two components has become outdated. Call me sappy, but I'm pretty loyal to my computers until I've totally outgrown them. If you're like me, know that just because you have an older computer doesn't mean you can't take advantage of newer technology. This MacBook shipped with an 802.11g airport card, but that doesn't mean it's stuck with it for life. Upgrading your airport card is super easy and will probably only take you 15 minutes. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you how to upgrade the airport card in your MacBook. This video is just an overview, so as I upgrade this MacBook, I'll try to give you some tips on the trickier parts. You'll notice it's actually pretty easy, but still, you'll want to follow the step-by-step instructions and the repair guide on our site. The MacBook I'm working on is an original Core Duo model. If you're not sure which kind of MacBook you have, head to the ID Your Mac page at iFixit.com, because different versions of MacBooks use different airport cards. As far as tools are concerned, you don't need a whole lot to do this repair. I've got a Phillips 00 screwdriver from our 26-piece bit driver kit, a plastic spudger, a coin, a replacement airport card, of course, and I also have a screw tray, which isn't totally necessary, but there ends up being a lot of screws, and this helps keep them organized, so I would recommend that. Now that I've got all of my parts and tools laid out, I can get started. First thing I'm going to do is use my coin to unscrew the battery locking screw, and the battery should come right out. And now I can see three screws down here that I'm going to loosen with my Phillips 00 screwdriver. And once they're all loosened, this should just come right out. With all of those screws loosened, I can remove the memory cover. And now I'm going to take out several screws to get the top case off. Make sure you're following the repair guide because you don't need to remove every single screw that's visible. Only the ones that are indicated in the repair guide. Now that I've got all of my screws removed and organized, I can flip over the computer and start removing the top case. I'm going to start towards the back of the computer. Slowly work my way towards the front. If you end up having trouble with the latches near the trackpad, you can kind of use your spudger to go along the edge, and then when you hit a latch, just gently rotate it, and that will unlatch it. Once you've gotten the last latch unlatched, don't yank the top case off because there is a ribbon cable attaching it to the logic board and you don't want to damage that. So with that cable disconnected, we can remove the top case and immediately we can see the airport card. There are only two screws and two cables keeping it attached to the logic board. So I'm going to use my spudger to disconnect the cables. Gently, and my screwdriver to remove the two screws. And with those out, the airport card should slide out of the computer. All that's left for me to do is install my new airport card, reassemble my MacBook, and I've got wireless in without needing to buy an entirely new computer. Of course, you can find all the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions on the MacBook Repair Guide on our website. Thanks for watching and happy repairing.